My dear friend now, Marco Bonatello, and the International Secretariat for all the support they've given to this committee. Without their support, we couldn't achieve anything that we have achieved so far. And also, I must thank the members of this committee. Without your valuable help, we wouldn't be able to report on you today. Now, let me remind you what was our mandate when this committee was created, what we've agreed to do, what you told us to do. You told us that on that critical issue of terrorism, we must give a parliamentary response, but we must not duplicate. We don't need another body doing the same work that other expert bodies do. That we must add some value, and we must bring forward parliamentarians of the OECPA working towards that end. Now, let me remind you that from the last year where I reported to you, we had the following situation at the OECD executive structures. The Austrian presidency at that time had prepared a document. The document was not agreed, although it was very well prepared. And I told you last year that we are going to present a resolution in that assembly based on that document. That's what we did last year in June, July, when was our meeting. That's what we did, and thanks to you, we had a unanimously agreed resolution on combating terrorism and violent extremism and radicalization that leads to terrorism. This approval of this resolution was very well received practically everywhere in all the stakeholders that deal with terrorism. And it was a specific act of the will of this assembly to take this issue seriously and to deal with it seriously. And I must thank all of you for that decision, because this was actually the base on which we worked the rest of the year. What else was very important? I'm not going into details in the report. The report is quite lengthy, and you got it. If you're interested, read it. Too many activities. But I will stay in the main political issues that should be addressed, and I'd like to come to that now. The main question is, what, I remind you, that was always the question. What a parliamentary assembly can do besides adopting a resolution? Resolutions are good. They set the basis. But is there something more than we can do as parliamentarians in order to contribute to the international fight against terrorism? That was the main question. So, what we said last year, and what I'm going to report to you today, is that we are going to be pushing for the implementation of specific obligations and commitments undertaken by the states, by governments, and we are going as parliamentarians to push for their commitments, our governments. So the idea was that now we unite parliamentarians in a major fight where we hold accountable our governments and we ask them to do what they have agreed to do, especially in specific commitments which derive from resolutions of UN. And this resolution specially concern a very important aspect of dealing with terrorism, and that is border security. So that was a new thing, because in that sense, Parliamentary Assembly now works as a pressure group, brings the international obligations forefront, parliamentarians start fighting and asking questions and asking governments, why you didn't do that? You should have done that. If you haven't done that, when are you going to do it? If you are delaying, why are you delaying? And what's the result of that? So we had a questionnaire which was sent to you. It was signed by President Cerretelli and myself, asking you to control your governments of if they applied the PNR and the API and the biometrics, which are three specific things that derive from UN resolutions. All governments have agreed to do that. So let's see, have they done it? Because as the situation in the international fight against terrorism is evolving, we are actually winning the war on the ground, so they don't control ground anymore, well, much smaller ground, to be accurate. But on the other hand, new challenges derive from that. Because as now, they don't have, let's say, a space, now they come to flee, they come back. So you have the return of foreign fighters. If borders are not controlled, then what we face is what we have faced exactly in the past. We have faced attacks, organized attacks, in our countries. Now, the organized attacks, because they are losing the war, are now diminishing, but we have a rise of the attacks of the lone wolves, exactly because this is a bit disseminating, and this is a new challenge, much more difficult to address. Practically, we have a rise on these attacks, and almost all countries have suffered at least one casualty, one dead, by terrorist attacks. So border security is at the forefront. It's very important for us. We've asked you to work on that, and I am pleased now to report that we got your answer back. 16 parliaments have asked the respective governments of what they have done. We are waiting some more answers. Up to now, 30% of the countries, of the parliaments participating in this assembly, they have asked this question. I think we will arrive, we estimate, at 50%. And I must say that for this new exercise, this is a very encouraging result. I must thank you for that. I must thank you for the dedication. And I must tell you that this is highly appreciated now at all levels. Because we have organized a meeting at the UN. Now the UN wants to work with the Parliamentary Assembly towards that direction, because now they appreciate the role of parliamentarians and what they can do in the fight against terrorism. So we are going, that's a project we're going to be working on. We're going to be working on a memorandum of understanding of cooperation between UN and us. I think UN appreciates OSCE as the principal regional security organization, and it is approved and considered like that. So this is a very specific role that we have to play, plus a new idea stemming out of that comes into play, and that is the coordination of all parliamentary assemblies towards that direction, and that includes the IPU, PACE, it includes PAM. So parliamentarians from all over the world now, they're going to be working towards that goal. And we're going to be meeting, we are co-organizing a meeting in St. Petersburg this April with, of course, CIS is going to be there. It's going to be actually hosting the event. But we are co-organizing that with other parliamentary assemblies. And this is going to be the big event of parliamentarians in front or in the forefront of fight against terrorism. So this is the way we're going to head. But I must say that this again would not have been possible without some specific achievements that are owed to people in the committee. And I must say here that we have organized in Spain with the initiative of our colleague Ignacio Cosido a meeting in the Spanish Senate concerning the victims of terrorism, which is a specific aspect, very sensitive and very complicated. We have had an amazing meeting in France, organized by our colleague, by our colleague Aude Van Dorn, which was actually very successful, handling with a very, especially concerned with a very special, difficult and sensitive problem, which is the return of minors from the areas with foreign fighters as they return. Maybe they are minors, or maybe they come with their parents. Their parents, they have to go, they're going to be incarcerated. How you deal with that situation? We had the opportunity in Paris, in this great meeting we had, to hear from experts how they are dealing with that situation. But I must also praise United States, and especially our colleague Richard Hudson, for organizing meetings with all the stakeholders in the United States. Very important, and you see there that even from the other side of the Atlantic, they have to face practically the same challenges that we face now. So where we go on from here, that's what I'm telling you. There are too many activities, too many contributions. I'm not going to go into all of that. If you're interested, get the report. But where do we go from here? First, we must insist that the states, governments, they're going to do their work. They must secure borders, they must implement API, PNR, biometrics. Let's keep on pushing on that. Those that you have not asked the question, ask the question. We need the feedback, because now we are processing this feedback in order to get specific results. So this is very important. Second, coordination with all parliamentary assemblies. And third, MOU with UN, closest cooperation with OSCE executive structures. I must thank from here Spain, and especially Ambassador, let me get the name. Ramon, exactly, because she was heading the security committee, and really she appreciated the work being carried out by our committee. We had the closest here cooperation, and indeed with OSCE executive structures, I think things couldn't go better. We are working closely with them. And again, I must stress, which is quite disappointing, it's quite disappointing that at this executive structure, at the state level, again this year, under Italian presidency, they couldn't find an agreement or a common ground for a resolution that they're going to unite the states. So again, the burden lies in you, in the parliamentary assembly, to carry on the work that it's not finished, it's being carried out, but it's not finished by the executive structure. So actually, three things. We keep on pushing by controlling the states. We organize our work in counterterrorism with other parliamentary assemblies and the UN. And of course, we carry on the work with the executive structure. I think that now we can go back to our citizens and to our electorate, and we can say that we are doing something concrete and specific to secure their lives against the threat of terrorism. Thank you.